Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install Visual Studio in your Windows 10 operating system. And then I will also show you how to set up your Visual Studio code for C and C++ programming. So let's begin. Now to install Visual Studio in your Windows 10 operating system, first you need to download it. So for that, just simply click on your favorite browser. And in here, just type Visual Studio code. And now you will see our first link that came is this code.visualstudio.com. So you need to click on this Visual Studio code. So just click on that. And in here, you will see this download for Windows. So just click on that. And now you will see that this Visual Studio code setup has been currently downloading. Now I have already downloaded it, so I just simply cancel it and I will go to my download directory. And in here, as you can see, this Visual Studio user setup installation file is there. So what I'll be doing is I'll be just simply double click on it and I will minimize this download directory. And now just simply accept the license agreement and then just simply click on next. Yeah. And now this is going to be your this installation directory, so for which I will be keep this all default. And as you can see over here that you need to have at least 245 MB of free space for this installation, so you just check that. And now just simply click on next. Yeah. And now this is basically this Visual Studio code is basically our name of our directory, and they are asking whether you want to create a start menu folder or not, for which I want to create a start menu folder, so I will not check that. I will just simply keep this all default and then just simply click on next. And now in here you can see that they are basically asking whether you want to create a desktop icon, so for which I'll be checking this. And also they are basically asking whether we want to open with code action in Windows Explorer, so for which I am going to check this. And also I am going to check this, open the code with a Windows Explorer directory in context menu. These options are going to be very much useful. And also this is the most important thing, you need to check this add to path. This is very important, otherwise you cannot run your code from other directory. You need to set this environment variable, so you need to check this path. This is very important. And now just simply click on next. Now just install. And now as you can see that this installation has been rightly began. It will take a minute or two, so for which I will come back once when it gets done. And now as you can see that this Visual Studio code setup has been rightly completed. So I'll just simply click on finish, and this will launch our Visual Studio code setup. So this is basically what you will get once this Visual Studio code is launched. And now I will show you how to install a compiler so that you can run this C and C++ programming in your Visual Studio. So for which first what I'll be doing is just simply cancel it. And now I will just simply go to our browser and then just simply first close this all things, open a new tab and then cancel this. And in here what I'll be doing is I will be downloading this MinGW compiler. And now the first thing you will get this sourceforge.net. So just simply click on this MinGW minimalistic GNU for Windows download. So just click on that. So basically we are going to download this MinGW from this SourceForge website. So now in here, just click on this download. It will show you your download will start shortly. So just wait for 2-5 seconds. And now as you can see, this MinGW setup wizard has been rightly downloaded. So just open the folder. And now as you can see in this download directory, this MinGW setup wizard has been rightly there. So just double click on it to install. And now just minimize this download directory. And now in here as you can see, this MinGW installation manager setup tool has been rightly launched. Now just simply click on install. and this is basically the directory where this MinGW going to be installed. So if you want to change your installation directory, then you can just simply click on change and you can change your installation directory. But I will, you know, keep this all default and then simply click on continue. And now as you can see, it's showing that connecting to pr/downloads.sourceforge.net. So basically you need to have an active internet connection right throughout the installation. As you can see, this downloading is currently in progress. So I will just simply fast forward it and come back when it gets done. And now we'll simply click on continue. And now in here, in this MinGW installation manager, they basically gave you these options to install. So for which, you know, I will be clicking mark for installation, then mark for installation. Just right click on it and then just mark for installation. Now just go to this installation and then just simply click on this apply changes. Yeah. And now in here, just simply click on apply. And now as you can see, this basically downloading is progress. So it will take a minute or two. As I have already mentioned earlier, you need to have an active internet connection right throughout the installation. So it will take a minute or two. So for which, you know, I will come back once when it gets done. So welcome back. And now as you can see, this downloading has been rightly completed and the files are now getting extracted and going to be installed. So you know, again I will come back once when it gets done. So now as you can see that these all changes are applied successfully. So now you can simply close this wizard, and again you can close this. And now just simply click on this command prompt, and in here type /g++\version. Now even after this MinGW installation, it is showing that G++ is not recognized as an internal or an external command. Now this is because this environment path has not been shared. So for that, just simply close that and then just go to your C directory, and in here you can see that this MinGW has been installed over here. So just click on that and then go to this bin directory, and now just go to this address bar, and here if you type cmd then enter, and now if you type g++\version, you will see that g++, that is this mingw.org gcc 6.3.0 has been rightly installed, but it's not showing in that directory. That's because, as I have mentioned earlier, the environment path has not been shared. So now you just simply, you know, copy this path. So just simply Ctrl C and then go to this search icon, and here type environ, and now just click on this edit system environment variables, and now you will see this pop up from this system properties. Now just simply click on these environment variables, and now under this system variable just click on path and then edit, and now you will see this edit environment variable will pop up. So now just simply click on new, and in here just simply paste by simply Ctrl V, and now as you can see that this mingw/bin folder has been rightly printed. Just now just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK, and now if you just close this and again open your command prompt, and now you are basically in your home directory, right? And now if you just simply type g++\version, and now just enter, and now as you can see that this mingw.org 6.3.0 has been rightly shown in our home directory as well. So now you just know that this environment path has been rightly set. And now that you have correctly installed this MinGW compiler in your Windows State operating system, now it's time to write a simple code snippet in C or C++ programming. So for we just simply click on your Visual Studio Code, just double click on it, and in here just simply click on this file and then new file, and now just simply save this file. So for we just simply hold this Ctrl S in your keyboard, And now just simply click on this document directory. This is where we are basically, you know, going to save our program files. And now just simply create a new folder, and in here just simply type C underscore programs. Now just enter. And now just simply enter again to go inside that directory. And in here you need to save this file as prog1.c. And now just simply click on save. And now as you can see that this file has been, you know, rightly saved as this prog1.c. And now we can simply write some C program. So for which, you know, I'll be writing a simple hello world program. Show hash include stdio.h, then int main, and just simple I will be printing hello world. So printf hello world. Now just a semicolon and return 0. Now just simply, you know, hold Ctrl S. And now as you can see that this program has been rightly saved. And now just simply click on terminal and then new terminal to open a new terminal in your, you know, this Visual Studio console. So now that as you can see that this terminal has been rightly opened. So in here as you can see that we are currently in the C user slash our username directory. So basically, as I have shown you that we have saved this program in our document directory, and then inside that document directory we have saved this program as C programs, right? So what we need to do is we need to go inside this directory. So for which just simply minimize it, cd documents, enter. And now just you go inside this document directory. So now you need to go inside that C programs directory. So for that just simply type cd c underscore program. Program or programs? Programs. So cd c underscore programs, then enter. And now as you can see you are inside this C programs directory. And now you can compile your C program. So for which just simply type gcc space prog1.c, enter. And now that your program has been rightly compiled, it has no errors. So just simply, you know, dot slash then a, now enter. And now as you can see in this console, this output has been rightly shown hello world. If you just, you know, just simply just slash n for a new line and then again save, and just again you know, compile this program and again run, you will see this hello world in a single line. So in this way, in Visual Studio Code, you compile and you run your C program. And now I'll show you how to compile and run a C++ program. So for which, just hold Ctrl and N to create a new file, and then Ctrl S to save. Now just go a directory back to your document directory, and in here you need to create another directory for C++ programming. So cpp underscore programs, that's it. Now just go inside that directory, and in here we'll save this file as prog1.cpp. This is very important. For C++ programming you need to save this file as .cpp extension. This is very important, you know. Now just simply save it. And now as you can see that this program1.cpp has been rightly, you know, saved. And now you need to write a simple hello world code snippet in this text area. So now just simply Ctrl S. And now in the terminal you are inside this C program. You need to go a directory back, right? Because you want to enter inside that C++ directory. So for which just simply, you know, cd dot dot to go a directory back. Now enter. And now as you can see that you are you went a directory back. And now you need to cd cpp underscore programs cpp programs, then enter to go inside that cpp programs directory. And now here you can simply compile the C++ program by just simply typing G++ your program name, that is this prog 1.cpp. Now just simply enter. And now as you can see that your program has been rightly compiled and it has no error. And you can simply run this program by simply typing .a and then enter. And now as you can see that this hello world has been rightly shown in our console. So in this way you compile your C program and C++ program in this Visual Studio Code. I have shown you both, and also I have shown you how to install this MinGW compiler in your Windows 10 operating system. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do share with your friends and please do like this video, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.